Hello everyone, welcome back to another video at Round 3 Design. This is Anya, and today I have a card that features the Honeybee Stamps Blah Bunny and the Honeybee Stamps Blah 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 sentiments that coordinate with it. And I'm starting with the bunny stamp in my MISTI. This is the original size MISTI, and I'm stamping on Bristol smooth paper with Versafine Onyx black ink. And again, I'm stamping multiple times lightly so that I don't lose any details, like his cute little toe beans. And then without cleaning off my stamp, I stamped the bunny onto a piece of Eclipse masking paper, and I'm just cutting this out. I was being very lazy and tried to only cut out parts of it that I thought I would need, but I end up cutting out the entire thing later. So I'll bring back my stamp and put the mask on it so that I can line up the rug or mat underneath him. It could be a beach towel if that's the kind of thing you're going with. And you'll see here when I get this lined up that I'm trying to angle it so I can be below the mask, but it just didn't look right. So I'm going to take the mask up and finish cutting it like I should have the first time. And I apologize for my gravelly voice. I'm still getting over a cold and I'm trying to carry on even though it's not sounding the best for you. And now I'm going to put my mask back on the right way, and you can see all of the black outline of the bunny because I cut my masks on the inside so that I don't have any shadowing when I do my overlay stamping here. And there's the little rug for him to lay on. This is not a happy type card that I'm making today, but sometimes we need to make the cards to encourage people or to let them know that we're here for them. Not everything that happens in our lives is wonderful and joyous, but we still need to be there and support everyone. And you can, I've zoomed in here for you so that you can see the coloring. I'm using my Zig Clean Color Rail Brush markers and my Faber-Castell syringe water brush pen. And as I'm coloring, I'm just putting the color in the places where I assume the shadow to be. I'm not being technical with this. It's not a major piece of art. I don't need to be exact. I'm just putting the color in and blending it out. For the body of the bunny, I'm using the marker in gray brown. And for the inside of his ears, his nose, and his little toe beans, I'm using blush. And then I'll blend those out on his ears as well. I'm going to leave it full strength on his nose and toe beans because it's so small, there's no point in blending that one. And then for the rug, I'm using, this is pale gray and light gray that I'm using here. This is light gray for the inside and pale gray for the outside. While I'm finishing up coloring here, I wanted to remind you that you can jump over to honeybeestamps.com and check out that blah, blah, blah sentiment stamp set. It isn't just for sympathy and I'm sorry cards. It has a few snarky comments that would be really fun to send to your friends. So here's a close-up for you so you can see all the coloring done. And now I'm going to fussy cut this out. This is very simple, easy to do, so I'm just making sure that I'm following along the edges slowly. These are curved edges around the rug, so I'm making sure I curve around those edges. And there's very few little cuts here. And you'll see I skip over and finish the rest of the easier section before I start doing the inner part of his tail. Normally I would go in and do reverse cuts, but because this is so shallow between his tail and the rug and his head, I don't need to do those reverse cuts. It doesn't make the paper bend. And then I'm going to take my Memento Tuxedo Black marker and go around all of the edges so that the white core doesn't show on this part. And that's it for that part. Now I've pulled out the card base, which is 4 1/4 by 11. And I've pulled out my swatch sheet for my Distress Oxide inks, and I've decided on Weathered Wood. I'm taking one of my makeup style blender brushes and I'm just lightly blending. I don't want this to be dark, but I do want it to have contrast. So I am tapping off before I start blending on the card base. I'm not adding any more layers to this card. It's just the single layer and the bunny. And I'm just blending kind of around him, so it looks kind of like a dark cloud, like he's just having a bad day. Now I'm going to pull out the blah 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 stamp set, And I've decided to go with I'm So Sorry, because this is very open. You can use it for any number of things. And on the inside, I've pulled out that bigger one that says I'm Here For You. So pulling out my original size MISTI again, I'm going to line this up with the MISTI Creative Corners comes with this L-shaped ruler. And I use it all the time for making sure my words and phrases are straight. So I'm just going to move it up to where I want it to go and stamp that. I'm going to stamp it a second time. Again, I stamp very lightly multiple times. It works much better to keep all of my detail. And then I'm flipping it vertically so that I have the inside of the card now, and I will stamp the greeting for the inside. It says, I'm here for you. I don't need to use the Versafine Onyx Black ink for the greetings because I'm not coloring over them, but it does give a really good crisp impression, and it is my go-to for all of my phrases as well. I'm going to clean off my brush and clean up a little bit here, put things away. Now I'm ready to adhere my bunny to the front. I'm going to get my EK Success Reverse Grip Tweezers, and this is Tombow Mono Multi-Glue, and I've put it into a fine line bottle. These yellow bottles come with an 18 gauge tip, but I put a 20 gauge tip on it instead because they are interchangeable. And that does it for this card. So thank you so much for coming to watch and liking and subscribing, thumbs upping, and I'll see you next time. Bye.